So this is the next chapter, that is chapter number 9. Okay, we will take introduction of this chapter, chapter number 9, that is coordination compounds. Okay, so in last chapter, that was transition and inner transition elements, we have studied, okay, the different transition and inner transition element, that is D and F block elements, okay, and how their properties that are varied. Okay, that also we have seen. Now we have to understand what is the coordination compound. Okay, so what is the meaning of the coordination compound? Okay, general basic introduction of this chapter. So coordination compound, okay, what is the meaning of that coordination compound? Okay, so this coordination compound, it consists of a central metal atom. Okay, what it consists of? It consists of central metal atom. Okay, it consists of central metal atom. Okay, it may be an atom or it may be the ion. Okay, ya to wo ion bhi ho sakta hai, central. Okay, ya fir wo central metal atom bhi ho sakta hai, and which is surrounded by atoms or molecule, and which is surrounded by either atoms or it may be a molecule, surrounded by atoms. Okay, or molecules. So that is called as the coordination compound, because we know that a compound consists of the different number of atoms that will take part in the formation of the compound. So a coordination compound will be formed when the central atom or the central ion, it is surrounded by either the different atoms or it may be surrounded by different molecules. Okay, in that case, that compound, complete compound, is called as a coordination compound. Okay, so the coordination compound, example, if we see a chemotherapy drug, okay, there is one chemotherapy drug and that name of this chemotherapy drug is called as cisplatin. Okay, cisplatin. So cisplatin, this cisplatin is having this platinum, this NH3 twice, okay, so NH3 twice, and it is having a Cl2. Okay, chlorine, two molecules, ammonia, NH3, two molecules, and one platinum. So now, which one is the central metal atom here? Which one is the central metal atom? So platinum being the central metal atom. So coordination compound in which a central platinum metal ion, okay, aap dekh sakte yahan pe central metal atom will be a platinum, and which is surrounded by two ammonia molecule, okay, two NH3, that is two ammonia molecule and two chlorine molecule, okay, two chloride ions, okay, or you can say this is a two chloride ions. So this complete compound is called as a coordination compound, because platinum, which will be acting as a central atom, okay, or central metal ion, and this ammonia, two molecules of ammonia are present, and two molecules of this fluoride, okay, are present. So in this way, this will be termed as a coordination compound. So the species surrounding the central metal atoms or ions are called as the ligand. So a species which is surrounded by, okay, which is surrounded by surrounded the species surrounding the central metal, okay, surrounding species surrounding the central metal atom, the central metal atom, central metal atom. तो अभी आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे प्लैटिनम के सराउंडिंग में कौन है, NH3 टू मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड दिस क्लोराइड टू मॉलिक्यूल्स आर प्रेजेंट, सो दिस विल बी टर्म्ड एज, दिस आर कॉल्ड एज द लिगैंड्स. ओके, एटम्स और आयन, दिस आर टर्म्ड एज अ लिगैंड. ओके, लिगैंड्स, LIGANDS. ओके, दिस आर टर्म्ड एज अ लिगैंड्स. सो द लिगैंड्स आर लिंक्ड डायरेक्टली टू सेंट्रल मेटल आयन. ओके, आप देख सकते हो यहाँ पे, इफ यू सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर, देख लेते हैं सबसे पहले, दिस इज अ प्लैटिनम, ओके, एंड दिस प्लैटिनम इज राइट नाउ it is attached with this NH3 molecule like this, and this is chlorine. Okay, Cl molecule is like this. So this is Cl chlorine molecule, chlorine, and this is another NH3. So in this way, this platinum being the central metal atom, and these are NH3, Cl, Cl, NH3. This will be termed as the ligands, because these are surrounded by, or these are surrounding, these are present in a surrounding to the central atom, central metal atom or central metal ion. Okay, and that's why these are termed as the ligands. So the ligands are linked directly to the central metal ion through coordinate bonds. A formation of a coordinate bond occurs when the shared electron pair is contributed by the ligand. Now what happens, coordination compound, when it will be formed? When there is a sharing of electron. Okay, when there is a sharing of electron takes place by ligands. Okay, when there is sharing of the electron takes place by the ligand, a coordination compound will be formed. Okay, a coordination compound will be formed. So when coordination compound will be formed, when these ligands, object sector NH3, NH3, chlorine, chlorine, this, when they will share their electrons to the central atom, okay, and this will be and this will be called as a coordination compound. Okay, this will be called as a coordination. A formation of coordinate bond or coordinate compound occurs when shared electron pair is contributed by ligands. Okay, so sharing of electron or sharing pair of electrons. So coordination compounds having a metal ion in the center are common in cisplatin. Two ammonia molecules and two chloride ligands utilize their lone pairs of electron to form bonds with the platinum. So aap dekh sakte ho, yahan pe already have drawn this. Okay, this structure where this NH3 two molecules and this chloride two molecules. Okay, so these are forming a coordination compound by sharing a pair of electrons to the central atom. Central atom. Okay, so the donor nitrogen. So here donor being. Okay, यहाँ पे देखते हैं donor कौन है यहाँ पे. Okay, so donor nitrogen. Okay, nitrogen is a donor here. Okay, यहाँ पे nitrogen is donor. Nitrogen and chlorine atom. Okay, so donor nitrogen and chlorine atom. These are the two atoms. One is two chlorine atoms and these two nitrogen atoms. So the donor nitrogen and chlorine atoms of the ligands are directly attached to and form a bonds with the platinum. So this chlorine atom and this nitrogen atom is directly attached with this central metal atom, that is platinum. Okay, to form a bond with platinum. So formation of a coordination compound can be looked upon as the Lewis acid base interaction. So we have already seen what is a Lewis, okay, and acid base. Okay, Lewis acid bases. So the ligands being electron pair donor are Lewis bases. Okay, so jo donate kar raha hai, okay, jo donor hai, usko kya bolenge hum log? So these ligands will be called as a Lewis bases. Lewis bases, and the one which accepts the central metal ion. So central metal ion. Right now the central metal ion kaun sa hai isme? Platinum hai. Okay, so being electron pair acceptor, ye kya kar raha hai? Electron ko accept kar raha hai. Electron pair acceptor, because it is accepting the electron. So once again we'll look here. Platinum, which is a central metal ion, and these NH3 NH3 and ClCl, these are the ligands that are surrounded, okay, that are present in a surrounding to this platinum. What is happening? These are sharing their electron pair, okay, and these will be termed as a ligand. Okay, so donor nitrogen and this chlorine, they are directly attached with this platinum. And this donor nitrogen and chlorine will have a Lewis basis. It will be termed as a Lewis basis. And this central metal ion, that is platinum, which is electron pair acceptor, which which is serving as a lewis acid over here. So which is called as a lewis acid, which is acting as a lewis acid. Because what is a lewis acid and lewis bases concepts we have already seen. So in this way, the formation of the coordination compound will take place like this. For the formation of coordination compound, there must be one central metal atom, or it may be central metal ion. It must be surrounded by either the atoms or the different molecules. Okay, then it will be termed as a coordination compound. And in that, these ligands must donate some electron pair to the central atom. Means the central atom will accept the electron pair, and these ligands will donate their electron pair. So this concept, this point you must be remember about this coordination compound. Okay, one which is accepting will be called as a Lewis acid, and one which is donating will be termed as a Lewis. So now, what are the different types of ligands that are present? Okay, so types of ligands, we'll see. Types of ligands. Okay, so what are the different types of ligands that are present? Okay, types of ligands. So ligands can be classified as monodentate or polydentate. Okay, it may be monodentate, or it may be a polydentate. Okay, mono means single. Okay, and poly means many. Okay, polydentate. So the depends upon number of electron donor atoms they have. Okay, so monodentate ligand, we'll see monodentate ligand. A monodentate ligand is a one where a single donor atom share an electron. Where single donor atom. Okay, jisme single donor atom is present. Okay, single donor atom which is present. Okay, which is donating. The electron pair which is donated in this case will be done by a single atom, and due to that it is called as a mono. Mono means single. The atom which is donating their electrons, okay, so there is a single atom which is donating their electron pair, and that's why this is termed as a monodentate. Okay. So share electron pair to form a coordinate bond with the central metal atom, and examples of such are the ligands. Okay, such ligands are, so examples of such ligands are the Cl minus. Okay, Cl minus ion, OH minus ion, then Cn minus ion. So that are the examples of these ligands that they will form a monodentate bond. Okay, coordinate bond. These are attached to metal, have electron pair on either, maybe, okay, these will have metal atom, ya to ye chlorine ho sakta hai, oxygen ho sakta hai, ya phir ye nitrogen atom ho sakta hai, which are donor atoms. Okay, which are donor atoms. So in this way, monodentate ligands are what? The ligands which is formed due to the atom which is donating, a single donor atom is present which is donating its electron pair, okay, to a central atom, so to a central metal ion. Okay, that will be called as a monodentate. Okay, so we'll see a further portion, that is polydentate, okay, ambidentate. Okay, in the next lecture mein dekhenge hum log, we will see the details. So this is a general description or general introduction of a coordination compound. So here we have to study about the different coordination compounds. Okay, so now we'll see what is a polydentate ligand. Okay, so monodentate means what? There is only one single atom which is donating the electron pair, that will be called as a monodentate electron. Now in case of polydentate ligand, okay, so a polydentate ligand has two or more donor atom. It has two or more donor atom. Okay, it is having two either two or more than two donor atoms it is having, which are donating their electron pair to the central atom. Okay, and these atoms are which are linked to the central metal atom. Okay, which are linked to central metal atom. Okay, which are linked to a central metal atom or ion, we can say. Okay, atom or ion. So in this way, the number of atoms which are present in the formation of such ligand, okay, are either two or more than two, and these are linked to a central metal atom, one which will donate their electron pair. So that's why they are called as a poly. Poly means many. So that many atoms that are attached with the central atom, and they will form a ligand. So the examples are ethylene, that is diamine, and oxalate ion. Okay, examples are EN, that is short form is ethylene diamine. Okay, diamine. Okay, which is represented as EN also. And oxalate ion. Oxalate ion. So what are these? We see. So each of these ligands possesses two donor atoms, and these are called as a bidentate ligand. Okay, that's why it is called, termed as a bidentate. Bidentate means two. Okay, two atoms. It will have a two ligands, and that's why termed as a bidentate ligand. Okay, bidentate ligand. We have seen what is the meaning of monodentate, one single atom which is donating electron pair. Bidentate, which is the two atoms that will donate their electron pair. Okay, so example of this ethylene diamine, we'll see here. This is CH2 and this is CH2. Okay, ethylene diamine. Okay, ethylene diamine. So in this way, NH2. And in this way, this NH2. So आप देख सकते हो यहाँ पे, okay. So in this way, आप देख सकते हो NH2 suppose, okay. So this nitrogen is donating their electrons to this ethylene, and this will be termed as a ethylene diamine binds to a metal using electron pair on each of its two nitrogens. Okay, each of its two nitrogen, and it is forming a bidentate ligand. Similarly, oxalate ion. Okay, oxalate ion, that is oxalate ion. Oxalate. So this is ethylene diamine. Now oxalate ion, we'll draw oxalate ion, and this oxalate ion is having C2O4. That's 2-. Which utilizes electron pair on each of the its negatively charged oxygen atom upon linking with the metal. Okay, so this is one carbon atom, and here oxygen. Oh, okay, minus charge 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5, 6. This is another oxygen. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. This is another oxygen that is having double bond. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5, 6, and this is another oxygen with where it is having a single bond with this oxygen. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, and 5, 6 with one negative charge. Okay, so in this way, this is oxalate ion. Okay, utilizes electron pair on each of its negatively charged oxygen atoms upon linking with the metals. Okay, so ethylene diamine, then tetraacetate ion binds to a metal ion by electron pairs of 4 oxygen and 2 nitrogen atoms, and it is termed as a hexadentate ligand. So there are different types of ligand that will be formed. Hexadentate ligand also. Okay, so in this way, the example of this hexadentate is ethylene, that is diamine tetraacetate. Ethylene diamine tetraacetate. And in this way, if you will draw the structure, is very lengthy. Okay. So it is having ethylene, that is CH2, CH2 in the middle. CH2, CH2 in the middle. Then diamine. Okay. So it is having this nitrogen atom, two electrons. And here it is also having one nitrogen, these two electrons. And where it is attached with this CH2. CH2 carbon, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is a 5, 6. Here it is oxygen O minus, that's why 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This extra one electron. Okay, same is here CH2 C. Okay, double bond oxygen. Okay, so this is a big structure. Okay, up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 minus charge. Same will be drawn over here. Okay, nitrogen. Then CH2, then carbon, oxygen here 1, 2, 3, 4. Oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, one minus charge. Here carbon double bond, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, one negative. So this is a large structure of this ethylene diamine tetra 4 acetate. Okay, tetra acetate. So here ethylene diamine tetra acetate, this EDTA 4 minus ions binds two metal ions by electron pair of 4 oxygen, electron pair of the 4 oxygen atom. Okay, and 2 nitrogen atom. Okay, electron pair of 2 oxygen atom by electron pair of the 4 oxygen atoms and 2 nitrogen atoms. So in this way the ligands which are formed will be called as a hexadentate ligand. Okay, so hexa means 6. Okay, 4 oxygen and 2 nitrogen atoms. In this way it is forming a 6 ligand. 6 means hexadentate ligand. Okay, so more about this we'll see in further lecture. So in this coordination compounds we have to see these formation of such ligands. Okay, and the different compounds in the coordination compounds.